Reading of the ammeter in the circuit is. Before we go into the reading, let me draw a zoomed in diagram of the same. There is a cell to which there is a 2 ohm resistance. To this there is connected another cell. Okay. There is a 2 ohm resistance over here. This part over here will be there is a 2 ohm resistance and there is an ammeter. So basically we have to find out the current in this resistor. Okay, basically we have to find out the current in two resistors. This is 2 volt, this is 2 ohms, this is 2 ohms, and this is 2 ohms. At the bottom there is 2 volt. Okay, so let me first mark the points. This will be equal to A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, let the current over here at point C, let the incoming current be equal to I1. Let the incoming current at the point C be equal to I2. So the outgoing current will be equal to I1 plus I2. Okay. So if I apply the loop, if I apply the loop over here, it will be equal to, let me apply the loop law first. In loop A, B, C, H, A. Okay, A, B, C, H, A. So it will be equal to negative 2. It will be equal to, since we are going in the direction of the current in the 2 ohm resistor at the center will be equal to negative 2 I1 plus I2. And the current after the resistor, after that resistor, that is this 2 ohms, will again be equal to I1, will again be equal to I1. So it is equal to negative 2 I1 will be equal to 0. If I divide the whole equation by 2 it and minus 2, it will be equal to 1 plus I1 plus I2 plus I1 will be equal to 0. So basically 2 I1 plus I2 will be equal to minus 1. Let this be equation number 1. Then I will apply the same loop law in loop G, D, E, G, D, E, F, G. Okay. When I apply in this loop, it will be equal to 2 I1 plus I2. It will be equal to plus 2 I2 in the opposite direction. So it is equal to plus 2 will be equal to 0. Okay. The cell is connected somewhat like this. Okay. Again, if I divide it by 2, I will get I1 plus 2 I2 is equal to minus 1. Let this be equation number 2. I will multiply this equation, the second equation, by 2. So I will get over here, so I will get 2 I1 plus 4 I2 will be equal to minus 2. Then I will subtract this and this equations. So when I subtract those, it will be equal to 3 I2 will be equal to, it will be equal to minus 2. This is not equation. Okay, it's equal to minus 2. So it will be equal to, when I subtract both of them, it will be equal to negative 1. So I2 will be equal to negative 1 by 3. I2 over here will be equal to negative 1 by 3. When I substitute in the first equation, I2 will be equal to negative 1 by 3. So 2 I1, when this goes on the right hand side, it will be equal to negative 1 plus 1 by 3, which is over here equal to negative 2 by 3. So I1 also comes out to be negative 1 by 3. Okay, I1 and I2 are same over here, which is equal to negative 1 by 3. So the total current in the center part will be equal to I1 plus I2, which is equal to negative 1 by 3 and negative 1 by 3, that is equal to negative 2 by 3. So the total current in the ammeter will be equal to negative 2 by 3, which is equal to option number C.